Hey guys, welcome to No Ordinary Woman Chat Show. I'm your host, Miss Kazmak. Now guys, you know the instructions when you come onto the show. You know what you need to do. Call up the crew. Even call your enemy or do something. Just let people know that the show is about to begin because we have an amazing woman on the show. And I'm telling you, oh my God, when you guys see who we have in the studio, you're going to be like falling off your seat because literally I'm so gassed right now. You know, anyway, listen, let me stop chatting. Go put the kettle on, call your people and hurry up and join back onto the show. Well, join me on the show and watch No Ordinary Woman and meet this No Ordinary Woman. See you in a bit.
This summer, the United Kingdom will experience one epic night of praise. Greater Tour comes to the UK with award-winner International Praise and Worship Minister, Sherwin Gardner, on the 28th of July, 2017. Greater Tour launches Sherwin Gardner with his new praise and worship album, Greater, featuring Billboard-topping single, Because of You. Come and be part of this explosive night with classic hits like I Worship You. Sherwin Gardner's full live band, Ignite. Adding to this experience is Jamaica's own and UK favourite DJ Nicholas.
So when me take a breath, when me take a breath, take a breath, me can't believe the thing that women see.
Support by Emmanuel Smith-Halley and JC May and more. It's all taking place at the ARC Forest Gate, London, Friday on the 28th of July, 2017. Door open at 7 p.m. Tickets are available on Eventbrite or Facebook event page. For more information, call 07506 563 007 or contact at sherwingardner.com. This event is powered by Flowmasters, the ARC Artist Hub. A Step Forward, Premier Gospel and Vine Juice.
Hey guys, welcome back. Alright, so you heard what I said. We've got an amazing, phenomenal, oh my gosh. We've got a musical artist in the studio with us right now. Like, she is the bomb.com. Her name is Lurine Cato. Yes, you heard it correctly. Lurine Cato is here on No Ordinary Woman Chat Show. Oh my god! Oh my gosh.
You're crazy.
I know. I think everyone's starting to discover that I'm not really the full 100, but this is just the way that God made me.
That's right.
You know, so yes, Lurine, thank you so much for coming onto the show today. We are just so excited. I mean, you are just stunning.
Oh my God. So are you.
Thank you.
I was looking at that. We're working that makeup.
Thank you. Let me just stop the vanity here, yeah? Anyway, less about me. You guys know this. And what about you? So, Lurine, how did your journey start? Because, I mean, you're a MOBO award winner. I understand you've also won another award. It's an international European award as well. You've also won an award for Black Entertainment Film, Fashion, Television, Arts Award for singer as well. So, how did your journey begin? How did you end up even singing?
Gosh, that just came from God. Right. Though my parents used to argue who gave it to me.
Okay.
It was me. No, it was me.
Just trying to take the ownership.
I said, hey, it was both of you. Shoot, hey.
Yes,
But you know, I've been singing, oh my gosh, since I was three. Yeah, since I was 3 years old. So, I mean, not literally just singing in the house, but literally singing in front of people at conventions, at church and things like that.
Oh my goodness.
You know, I just had this massive voice and they used to put me on the table or chair at these conventions and just have the mic and sing.
What? So, I mean, from the age of three, you was doing all of that?
Singing.
So, literally, I mean, it's like, you just was born, started doing walking and everything, and then you've gone straight into your calling by the sounds of it.
Yeah, yeah.
So, I mean, so entertaining people, you've been doing it majority of all your life then, I think.
Yeah, all the time. I guess, you know, I have times when I've been nervous in the past and on certain gigs, especially maybe when I didn't know a song too good, and it's like you have to sing it like, oh my God, there's no words, you know.
Yes.
You know, so those nerves would kick in, but I'm you know, most times I'm confident and I know what I'm doing and all that, but yeah, it's just been years.
Wow. And so in regards to your singing as well, because I've noticed you've worked with like Donnie McClurkin, you've worked with like Mary J. Blige, Kylie Minogue, you was doing a world tour with as well. I mean, how did those opportunities fall into your lap? I mean,
Well, in the church that I was growing up in, Calvary Church of God in Christ, Kojic,
right.
There were a lot of musicians in uh-huh. there. And I was in the headquarters church in Tottenham, Northumberland Park.
Right.
So we had about three choirs in that church. You know, we had the young people's choir, the old people's choir, and then was the us little ones, you know.
Oh, wow.
And a lot of top musicians who... These musicians were playing for Chaka Khan. They were playing for so many people, the American artists, gospel artists as well. So I was quite fortunate that when we used to have conventions, other people from other churches used to come down and musicians. And, you know, when you're singing, you're like, people see me grow. Mm. And so I remember this musician, I think his name was Luke Smith. He asked me to do some backing singing for an American artist that was coming over. To the Barbican, and that was my first backing singing thing.
And how old was you, roughly?
18.
Wow.
18 at the time. And so, but unfortunately, the American artists didn't turn up, and there's like 2,000 people there. And it was at that, I mean, it was my first backing singing job. And at that time, the promoters asked, they heard that I could sing, and they said, could you sing?
Hold on.
We heard.
So, is this because the artist didn't turn up?
Yeah.
So they asked you to then come step forward and then you just basically do the show?
Yeah. Headline the show.
My gosh. Yeah. So that...
And there was... And I remember...
and it was 2,000 people. Sorry, you said 2,000...
2,000 people were there. And they were... LCGC was singing that night because they were support act.
Right.
There was another artist there. So they said, yeah, can you headline? And I remember I was so nervous I could see myself doing that. But I was prepared.
Yeah.
Because I've always loved learning songs and all that. And I thought, if I had to sing somewhere, then I would sing that, that and that. So it went from being backing singer and then from sharing a changing room to having my own.
Wow, that is instant promotion.
It was just nuts. And they said, Lurine, we're gonna go through your songs, come around the back. So I thought, okay, one thing, I could do an a cappella by myself. And I remember they also asked Jocelyn Brown
right
to come down and sing as well because of what happened.
Mm-hmm.
And she was like, they were saying to Jocelyn, when do you want to go on, before Lurine or after Lurine? She goes, Lurine, when do you want to go on? I went, oh, me.
Jocelyn Brown, oh my goodness.
And this is the crazy thing. A week before that, I was at a concert with my sister and husband to see this jazz singer called Carmen Lundy at World Festival Hall.
Right.
We went round the back, was talking. Jocelyn Brown was round there, and that was the first time I met her. And she was giving me advice next weekend after that.
God nuts. Is good.
Ain't that nuts? And she said, Lurine, when do you want to go on? And I'm like, I'll go in before you.
My goodness.
And then I sang. I done like a jazzy version of Amazing Grace with the band and all that. And I got a standing ovation. It was nuts. And they were asking, has she got album? Has she got... Not my audience.
Yeah.
So, that I'll say that was like my... Though I sang loads of times, but that was like my main, you know, I thought, I could do this.
But then hearing you, it's like God was literally preparing you because he knew the kind of audience he's going to put you through, you know, forward to perform, to entertain, etc. So it wasn't on a, you know, a small scale. He was preparing you for that.
Yeah.
My God. And then obviously now you've got your new album that's out. Chosen to Serve.
Yeah.
How did this title come about? Because I love the fact Chosen to Serve. It's just like, why Chosen to Serve? I mean, it's a great title. Don't get me wrong. I love it. But if you can just share with the viewers, how did the title come about?
Well, it's oh my gosh, it all goes back to my testimony of course, growing up in church, growing up singing and all that kind of thing. And the time when I became, when I decided I wanted to get baptized at the age of 13, something dreadful happened to me. Someone groomed me for years from the age of 13 to 21, and I was molested by, I'll say, two people, and then someone else just tried as well. So it was quite devastating. But I was also in church and this, and, you know, I love God, but I knew that this dark side, other side of things was happening to me, which I didn't understand. And I always said to God, why are you striking this person down, you know? But I still love God, because even at church, I was still praying for people at church.
My God.
But at school, I was fighting people.
Yeah.
And that's where I found my power. You know, at home, I was just Lurine. And I had this dark secret, you know what I'm saying? And wanting to tell people, you know, so when, after going through that, cutting a long story short, I went into wrong relationships, because you have this thing over you where you attract the wrong people. So when I got into the wrong relationships, I ended up being raped and beaten and left in alleyway, and sometimes left in the bush, you know, at night time. Crazy stuff happened to me, you know. And and it wasn't until, I think, 2005, you know, after having two little children, and I realised, and plus going through suicide as well, wanting to commit suicide, to the point of, I went to London Bridge to jump off, and it was, it's actually at the side of London Bridge, so it's like, you know, where people usually walk, and there was no one there. And I was just like, ready, just go. And God said, if you jump, you're going to float because you're wearing a puffer jacket. And it just stopped me. I just thought, I don't fancy floating on my back. Things. Someone help me, please.
Oh, my God.
You know, so it stopped me. And but that didn't stop me. I tried different tablets. And they said, oh, you know, go end up going to the hospital. They said, oh, these tablets were harmless. I'm like, what? You know, vexed, come all this way. Going back home thinking, you know, I really wanted to end my life. I thought, what's the point? You know, I'm just keeping getting hurt. I don't know how to get out of. I'm all, there's always drama around me. So much drama and all that. So, so like I said, 2005, after having two children, I just, it was after I had this fling with this guy, God just, it was, that was it, you know. And I said, God, I'm going to surrender my life to you. I want to know what it's like to be a true Christian. When I say true Christian, it's not about lying, you know, because people are Christians and they lie. They go, oh, a little white lie. White lie will take you straight back
to
hell.
Come on now. It's sin, isn't it?
It will take you straight to hell.
It's sin.
You know, it's sin, it's sin. And I used to lie a lot, saying, oh, if I didn't go home, like, oh, Mum, I'm at the studio because, you know, we've got to work hard and I'm at my boyfriend's house. You know what I'm saying? And all these things happening. And so when I decided that I wanted to surrender my whole entire life to God, he literally did what the song says. He breaked me, melt me, molded me into the woman I've always dreamt of being. I'm telling you, I've always dreamt of being, because I just felt like I'm the only one in that, in this family. There's 11 of us that's got a whole heap of drama. Like, oh, do you know what happened to me? What happened now?
You know? So you know, just want to be that one to
It was just like, no one took me seriously. It was just like, oh, what now? What's, you know? And I just wanted to know what it's like to have that relationship with God like my mum had. And so when God took me on this journey, which I called my, when you're in like a cocoon, I call it my cocoon. I was in the cocoon for 5 years. I stopped singing. I stopped touring. I was offered millions to join, be the front singer of big bands, and I just didn't. And he took me on this journey, and when he, and supernatural things happened, things like I felt angels lift me and take me around my bedroom. Angels used to talk to me in my ears and give me, there's so many things. That one night, I half of my body weight went in the, while I slept, and woke up a different body weight, you know.
So how did, I mean, I'm just listening to you. I'm just like taken aback. I didn't even, it's just like, oh my gosh, how did that feel? I mean,
it was nuts, because my sister saw me one the day before in one way. Saw me the next day, she went, what happened?
My you know. Gosh.
And then it was that day when God said, I want you to start eating veg. Fruits. I didn't know it was a Daniel fast. I just thought, okay, I just got to do what God's telling me to
do. Absolutely,
I could hear his voice so clearly, you know. So he would just say, just do that. And I've just, and during this time when I'm on this journey, my mum and dad were sick and I was looking after them. I didn't know that God was shaping me and preparing my character, how I'm going to be, you know. Right. And I've got two children, I'm looking after mum and dad. All these things are happening.
So it's like you become a servant, really, isn't it?
Yeah.
Literally.
Serving. And my mum said, I'm sorry you have to do this. I'm like, Mum, it is a honor to do this, you know what I mean? Because I've given you so much rubbish.
Yeah,
in my life.
It's the least I can
do. Even though some things weren't my fault, but there were some things it was like, you know, I gave you hell. Do you know what I'm saying? And you know, and so for me, I'm so glad that my parents saw the change.
Yeah,
do you know what I mean? And so you know, I was going through all of this, and even things like having a bill, a gas bill that was like. £300 or £500, and they tell me you're gonna have to pay this, and I put them on mute. I'm like, God, he's gonna tell me that he's gonna clear it as soon as I take it off mute in Jesus' name.
You know that.
Do you know what, we're gonna clear it. Thank you. Oh, thank you so much.
Praise God.
Things like that. I prayed off cancer off my friend. So many things happened in that time, and then when God broke the news to me that he wanted me to go back out and sing, I was like, no. Not doing it. I said, God, I'm good. I'll just help people. That's what I'll do. I'll just help, you know, because I was taking in mothers with their kids who were depressed and suicidal, even with my kids, and I was on benefits.
Yeah.
Right.
And you're doing all of this.
I'm doing all of it. I was taking in, looking after them, because they were like on antidepressants and all that. And I just thought, let me get them back to one of the mothers. She was so like out of it. She's now a singer doing stuff around the another mother. She's now got three jobs and her son's an actor, you know. It's just so many, and God's like, you're going back out. I'm like, no God.
But why did you not want to go back out?
I was a different person,
right?
I felt like that world is not for me anymore,
right?
You know, but God said basically he knew that I was ready,
right? So
I had a different character.
Yeah. So he was preparing you again, because obviously he's shown you the gift from when you was three,
right?
And now the gift, obviously, with everything that's happened to you and everything else, and obviously those are extremely, you know, really bad things, and I can understand even why you would be depressed and want to commit suicide, etc. But the fact of the matter is, he still kept you, and even though you're serving, you know, he prepared you so that you would have a different heart for him.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Totally.
Kind of thing.
Totally.
But what I'm getting here is that the gift is what he's created you to do.
Yeah.
Is to sing, is to minister unto people. Because you're beautiful, you're attractive, you're a stunning woman.
Thank you, girl.
But not only you're a stunning woman, you've got I can just feel this, your spirit is just so pure. You've got a beautiful spirit. So I can see that why people were engaged to you, why people want to listen to you and just, you know, be around you, because you're beautiful, you know? And just hearing your testimony, it's just like, it's making me want to really say to the viewers is this, no matter what you've been through, God will take you through. God will take you to the next end. Trust me. If you've done it for Lurine, he can do it for you. Do you know what I mean? And I'm just really just grateful that you didn't jump off that bridge, even though you would have float anyway. You know, it would have been cold. It would have just been wet.
It would have been awkward.
Yeah.
Very awkward.
But we just praise God, you know, for your life and what you're doing. I mean, obviously with your new album out, what would you say to somebody right now who's possibly going through, like, say, feeling depressed, may have been, you know, being molested or being raped? What would you say to that person, if you don't mind just speaking to the camera and just encourage that person?
You know, it's horrible and it sucks. It really does. And you do feel, you're going to feel like you're the only one in the world, and trust me, you're not. If you're going through it by yourself and you're thinking, I can't reach out to anybody, trust me, there's someone that you know you can trust. There's someone. You will never be alone. You will never be alone. Listen, Jesus was carrying the cross, but at some point while he was carrying it, someone helped him. You will never be alone. He will always bring someone there. Tell them you want to get out of this. You won't stay in this pain for long. I'm telling you, it's just temporary. And you will be healed. If I can be healed, some people are not healed over one little thing that they've been through, that I've been through. I've been like numerous of stuff. One little thing that I've been through, some people end up in mental institutes. Mm. You know, some people end up as on alcohol and total alcoholism and drugs and all that. You are still here. And I'm telling you, there is hope. Just reach out to God. Open up. You're thinking, but why did I go through this? I'm telling you, sometimes we go through things and we don't get the reason, but then you can turn it around and use it to help somebody else, like what I'm doing right now. Mm-hmm. I'm telling you, there's broken people out there. You can reach people that I can't reach. So I'm telling you, if you call out to God, I'm telling you, He will heal you. And ask Him, show me someone that I can trust to tell my story and get this pain and these horrible chains off me. And I'm telling you, you'll be set free.
Amen. Thank you so much, Lurine. Thank you. What I do want to speak about is your career in terms of being singing, you know, being a singer. And with the show, it is really just to encourage young women, young girls, etc., that they may have a burning passion to become a singer. Mm-hmm. They may not know what to do. How did you end up? I mean, obviously, I know in regards to what you've shared with your testimony and everything else, but how did you manage to get yourself back to where you are now in terms of singing, you know, because obviously you said you didn't want to do it.
Yeah.
So how did everything flip?
Well, when I didn't want to do it, God had to, I mean, He was sending me dreams and all that. He was sending me, like, He was just, like, talking to me. I was like, will you stop? Like,
yeah.
No. Like, and so I totally surrendered. And he said, I'm putting you back out there. And it was Jeremiah 29:11. You know, I do not think evil of you. That blew my mind, that scripture. Because I still thought, oh, I'm still dirty and all that. When He said, I do not think evil of you. But then when He, later on in the scripture, said, I'm going to send you back out there to help the captive, you know. And I thought, wow, you know, you're going to let me do that?
Yeah.
So when I did a deal with Him. I said, okay, so you want me to go back out there and sing? This is the deal. I want songs from heaven. I want original, clever lyrics and clever melodies that don't just touch Christians, but touch Muslims, people that just no matter what in the whole world, that when the stars hear my songs, they twinkle more. Yeah. That's what I said to Him. I said, what, the universe? I said, I want that, you know. So hence why every song that I've put out has done something. And even before I did this album, I was doing songs that went on to Warner, some compilation albums on Warner Brothers.
Praise God.
And I've got the disc.
Wow.
You know, I've got like two, but every song that I've written has done something, has made money or something like that.
Praise God.
And God has opened that way. So, you know, you really got to know your calling when it comes to anything you do. You need to know and lean on God and trust Him. And it's hard sometimes to trust because you're watching everybody on TV and all that. Just stay in your lane.
Yeah.
There's nothing like doing it God's time. My album took nearly 13 years to be complete.
But it needed to take 13 years. That was a plan.
Yeah.
You know?
It was a plan of God. And you know, because there's certain people that was attached to my album that God had to get rid of.
Right.
You know, there's certain things that happened. And God just brought it out. I said to Him, I bet you're going to bring this album out when the world is really dark.
And that's, look at the time now. Come on.
And I just had to, you know, I mean, I never forget a dream He gave me when I was in a place where I was just like, oh, when are you going to get me out there, God? When are you going? And I remember He gave me this dream where it was dark and there was a green grass. And in this green grass, there was this track, like a running track.
Right.
And there was floodlights on the track. And there was all these, we're about to do this race, and there was all these fit people lining up, and there's me just looking how I look. Look pretty normal. And all these people was like, yeah, and I was thinking, great. And then we started running around, and while I was running, there were people outside of the track sitting down waiting to be picked up.
Right.
And I had to pick every single one of them up. And the more I picked them up and put them on my back, I was slowing down.
Right.
And these people were still running, going fast. And then eventually they started to burn out. And I was still running and I was still picking up people and putting them on my back. But when I got to the finish line, which they didn't make, I was literally...
just getting there.
And got right over. And God said, see, your race is different than everybody else's. You are going to be saving souls.
Praise God.
And so that stopped me from thinking, oh, when am I going out there? What's happening? And
yeah.
It just, it changed my life, that dream, because my mission is different. That's why my motto and my theme is one vision, one purpose, one mission.
I love that.
And no matter what's going on around me, when people are going, oh, this singer, that singer. So I just want to say to singers out there and people that are aspiring to be a singer, make sure you have a purpose and make sure that God shows you who you've got to reach. Because I know that he told me to sing to the brokenhearted, you know. And it's not necessarily just doom and gloom songs. Mm-hmm. I've got some songs that make you gonna.
Yeah, because I like that power. Listen and purify me. Yeah. I should be a singer, you know.
Good girl, ain't impossible.
But you know what? That was not my gift. So I'm not even trying to claim it.
I just say, no, your gift, you know.
Well, I'm just saying.
No.
I should try it.
Still sing, still sing.
I sound good, yeah. I sound good, yeah.
You did, you did. It's all in key, everything.
Oh, thank you, Jesus. I'm going to sign up for praise and worship tomorrow.
That's right.
No. But yeah, but that's really great in the sense of what you're saying is, it's staying your lane and knowing your race.
That's
do you
it.
Know what I mean? Because I think when we look in society, it's so easy, especially as a woman, we compare ourselves and we look at this person, oh my gosh, they're doing this, they're doing that, what am I doing?
Yeah.
You know, you start to kind of really compare yourself with the other person, and really we should just celebrate each other. If that person's doing whatever they're doing, do you need any help? How can I help you? I've got a gift set in it.
Unfortunately, in the real world,
it's just sad. It doesn't,
look, well, Jesus had enemies.
Yeah.
Even in his camp.
In it, come on.
Do you know what I mean? You know, people, 1 minute he's healing people, next minute they're saying, crucified. Like, do you know what I'm saying? So it's going to happen. If he went through it, we're going to go through
Absolutely.
It. And, you know, but he will prepare you for the darts. He will prepare you for the fiery darts that will come your way. And you just got to have, I mean, in this business, you really got to have a thick skin and a very strong backbone, you know,
I can imagine.
And just deal with all what happens to you, because that's why you just got to be very prayerful. You know, I will have long times at home praying for a very long time, because I know what I have to do in front of me and what I have to deal with, the different people to deal with. So
yeah, because you're dealing with different spirits. You're dealing with a dark world out there, because obviously I've noticed that, you know, you're doing events and they're not particularly, they're secular events. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? So how do you actually deal with that? And then obviously, you know, then come into the church. How do you juggle the two?
Well, the thing is, God made me spy the land. When I was doing secular, dealing with secular artists, doing backing vocals for all these pop artists, you know, God let me experience all of that, you know, and dealing with people who were like big shotters. And, you know, I mean, I wasn't always behaving good when I was on tour. May I say, what happens on tour stays on tour, you know what I'm saying? Okay, I'm just saying, I did slip and slide, you know what I'm saying?
Okay, we ain't judging nobody,
you know,
we ain't no saints in it.
It wasn't easy, but I kept prayerful, you know, kept prayerful, and I repented many times.
Come on.
It's the truth. That's how it is, you know, because you get so caught up in that glamorous world. It's very glamorous. We were spot rotten. Every time I was on tour, it didn't feel like work.
Right.
You know, even though I was good at my job, we just got spoiled. We was on yachts. We was on, you know, we was asked to go in D&G. You got how much percentage off that. And,
and that sounds like my kind of, sounds like the lifestyle that I need to be in.
Well, it was ridiculous, and getting paid ridiculous amount of money each week for 6 months.
Gosh.
And then on top of that, you're doing other jobs. But it was just, but then, you know, but I did learn so much from all of that. And so I just want to say that it's you've really got to keep your head together. Mm-hmm. So the fact that I spied the land, I'm living in a world now where, because God had to completely change my character, yeah. change who I am. He goes, now you know how it's like mm-hmm. out there. Now that you are properly saved,
yes,
properly delivered,
yeah, amen,
and set free,
amen.
You can go back in that arena, yeah. but you know how to conduct yourself yeah. as a woman of God, amen. And you know you don't have to say I'm a Christian. You know I'm a Christian. Mm-hmm. They will already know. Mm. You know, so that's how I deal with it. God, mm-hmm. God trusts me. Basically, yeah. He trusts me.
Praise God, wow, that's just amazing.
And that's massive that he trusts me, because I didn't use to trust myself.
Yeah, and this is the thing, you know, because then when you really get to understand God in a sense of, I don't think anybody would completely understand God, but just knowing that he trusts you with just the little or the big or whatever, yeah, it's yeah. just like you're thinking, really, God, me?
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And it's quite humbling for you to even think like that, because some people think, well, you know, kind of brag about us, but he really humbles us.
Yeah, totally.
Do you know what I mean? And that's what I get from you're very humble as well. Mm. You know, I'm proper gassed about it, like your hair, you know, but you're just a beautiful woman. You just got a beautiful spirit. But let me stop. Okay, let's focus on the show, girl. Focus. All right. So what events have you got coming up currently, and what's going to be happening in 2017?
Okay, so I'm singing at an event tomorrow called the UK Entertainment Awards.
Right.
I've got that tomorrow evening. And there's a few concerts happening. I've got a big concert happening on the 30th of December. I think the Pastor Wade
right.
in South London.
Okay.
I'm doing like a big set with my band and singers.
Oh wow.
So I'm gonna sing some songs from the album.
Yeah.
And some other well known songs. So I'm looking forward to that. And if you know anything about me, I don't do the predictable stuff, because I dance as well. I can't keep still.
Yeah, I noticed. I love it. I love that, because you're entertaining and then people want to get
yeah,
down and
yeah,
think,
exactly.
Yeah, we don't know
some artists out there. Gotta dance.
You're dancing unto the Lord like David did.
Exactly.
You know, so praise God. Oh wow. So could you just tell the viewers where your social media platforms are, mm-hmm. so people can follow you on Twitter, Instagram, etc., all these social media.
I know.
Yeah.
Well, I'm on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube. What else am I on? I'm on all of them except for Snapchat. I'm coming. You know, check me out, and also you can check my website out. It's www.lurinecatomusic.com. Please hit me up. I'm very nosy. I want to know what's going on in your life too. So just, you know, just check me out. And also,
get Lurine's album.
Get iTunes, album. Google Play, and Amazon, and Spotify. Yeah.
Get an album. You won't be disappointed. And remember, you heard it on the Ordinary Woman Chat Show. So, as we're going to wrap up, I don't even want to wrap up, I just want you to stay with me, but you know, we could just talk behind the scene. No, you people ain't going to know anything, because what happens behind the scene stays behind the scene. So, I just put that out there. But I just want to say thank you for coming. Thank you for sharing your testimony, with us. And thank you for encouraging any of the viewers that may be looking to become an artist themselves. And like Lurine said, make sure it's from God. Do you know what I mean? Make sure it's that passion. It's not a thing that, you know, you just want to be a singer because, you know, I want to live this kind of lifestyle. You've heard it from the artist. I mean, she's gone through madness. And like she said, in that industry, you have to be thick-skinned. So really spend some time with the Lord and really just sit down and think about it, if this is really for you. And if it is, then good to go. So thank you guys for watching. Until next time, peace out. No ordinary woman, that's who you are. See ya.
feeling ill, tired and drained out? Need a natural approach to medicine at an amazing price? Bod's Natural Products are the answer. We have a range of products packed with an excellent source of vitamins and minerals that will improve your immune system and eliminate toxins. They can also help in the management of high blood pressure, diabetes and many other symptoms. So why not do your body a favor and try Bod's Natural Health Products today? Available at bodsnaturalproducts.com. That's www.bodsnaturalproducts.com and get your body in check.